Everyone, welcome back to the course Everyone Can Code. I hope your journey so far has been good. In the first module, we saw a few interesting problems like sum of digits, next multiple of 100, and three-digit palindrome. Now, while we were solving these problems, we also saw how we should approach our problems. What are the steps we should take while we are writing a problem, the five-step process. And also we learn about creating the right scaffolds and executing our programs time and again to check where our error lies or what our problem area is. So I hope you are familiar to all of it by now. Now in module 2, we are going to start with Eclipse. So I'll show you how to download Eclipse and how to set it up before jumping into the problem, that is natural numbers. So we'll install Eclipse, we'll create a workspace for our work, and we'll create a project. So let me quickly show you how we do that. So what you have to do is go to your browser and just type Eclipse download. Now once you do that, the very first link that shows is Eclipse IDE for Java developers from eclipse.org. So just click on it. And on the very first page at the right hand side here, you see all the download links for Windows 32-bit, for 64-bit, for Mac OS, for Linux 32-bit and Linux 64-bit. Now whatever configuration your system is at, you just click on that very link. So I have a Mac, so I click on Mac OS and then just hit download. I'm not doing it right now because I have already downloaded Eclipse on my system. So just hit download and follow the steps that are mentioned. Choose the directory where you want to download it and your process will be very smooth and easy. Now once you're done with the download, you get to see something like this. This is how the IDE looks like. So you have your package explorer on the very left. You have your console in Java doc and problems on the very right. And this is the part where your code is going to come at the center. Now we will start a new Java project. So once you start a new Java project, it asks you for the project name. Since we are at module 2, let me just say ECC. Now after this, when you are doing this for the first time, it will ask you for a workspace location wherein all your programs will be stored. So since I have used this before, it is showing me the default location of my workspace, which is users, Shikha Chaudhary, downloads, workspace, and then the project name ECC2. Now if you don't want to use the default location or when you are doing it for the first time, you'll get something like this. And you choose your location of the workspace by clicking on browse. So I'm going ahead with the default location here. And that's it. You click finish. And once you do that, you see ECC2 project created on the very left. Now after this, you click on your project, right click, and you see new. Now new class, package, project, whatever you want to do, all the options are present here. So we'll go ahead with new Java class. Alright. Before we move ahead here, let's just go back and see what our program is about. So in this video, we are going to write a method which returns a string containing natural numbers between a range of two numbers separated by a single space. So there are certain method specifications that we need to look at before we process further. If the given values are, let's say, 11 and 20, our program should return a string of natural numbers from 11 to 20 separated by a single space as shown in the slide. And if any given value is negative or 0, our program should return minus 1 saying that we have a negative value or we have 0 and we are not going ahead. If the first value is greater than the second value. So these are all the corner cases that we are keeping in check providing by the method specifications. So if the first value is greater than the second value, we return minus 2. Now coming back to Eclipse, to do this problem, let's first create our Java class. So since our problem is natural numbers, I'm just creating a class by the name natural numbers 01. Now the class has to be public and it has to have a main. So we just check that it has to have a main. It has to inherit abstract subclasses. You'll get to know all these things later on in the course when you have to use constructors and everything. So for now, we just go ahead with public static void main. Okay, and click finish. Once you do that, you see this code in place. Let me maximize this screen. Yeah. So you see this code in place, natural numbers one, public static void main, and the code is actually going to go inside the main. Now, if you have seen our assignment, you see that we have provided a dummy code for you to download and then build your program from there on. So here we'll use that dummy code, which looks like this. So you have natural numbers class, you have main, and inside main, you are simply calling the function get natural numbers, and we are passing a range. So 10 to 20, we want natural numbers between the range 10 to 20. Okay. And we have just created the structure of the function. So public static string get natural numbers. It is taking two input parameters, number one and number two. And we are going to add our code inside here. So as you notice, we are getting a red dotted line under our function name. That is because we have said that our function is going to return a string, but in our code, we are not returning anything. There's no return statement as of now. So that is why this is throwing an error, that add return statement. So it quickly gives you fixes that can take your warning or take your error of the code. So either you change your return type to void or you add a return statement. So let's go ahead and add a quick return statement. Now, as you can see, we just declared a variable result and initialized it to a blank string, and we returned that variable result. And as soon as we do that, now since we have returned a string, our error is immediately gone. Now, if you go ahead and try to compile and execute this particular program, it will very well work, but it will not give you the desired result. Let's see. We go to run. Save your program. Make sure you save your program before you run it every time. So this is your output as of now. Blank. Because we have returned a blank string. And that is what is coming here. Now let's move back to the program and see how we add the code. So first off, I want to start with checking the corner conditions. That is, if your numbers are less than or equal to 0, you return minus 1. And if your number 1 is greater than number 2, you return minus 2. To check this, we have written two very simple if conditions. The first if takes the first condition. If num1 is less than or equal to 0 and num2 less than or equal to 0, we simply go ahead and return minus 1. Similarly, in the second if condition where num1 is greater than num2, we go ahead and return minus 2. Now let's run and check if we are getting these values. So let's say our num1 is 22. So now first number is greater than second number. So this condition should fall inside our second if condition and our output should be minus 2. So just save the program and run. So minus 2. Now if we go ahead and change the second number to say minus 3, now our output should be minus 1. So we save our program and check if this condition is working fine. It is working fine. Now we go ahead to actually returning the strings between the two numbers. So for that, we start by writing a while loop. So our while loop runs from the first number till the number becomes less than or equal to the second number. Now inside the while loop, we'll check for one more condition. If your number 1 is equal to number 2. In this case, you just have to print one number as the output. So you just add that number to your string. Plus is equals to num1. So either you can write here num1 or num2, since both are equal, doesn't make a difference. So we just add this particular number to our num1. If both the numbers are not equal, in that case, what we have to do? Simply go ahead and add each and every one number from num1 till the end to our result. And since all the numbers have to be separated by a space, we add space after every number. So this is what our actual string would look like. The result, add the number and add the space. And once this while loop finishes, for the next iteration, every iteration, you just increase your num by 1. So let's say we have numbers in the range 10 to 20. So your num1 is 10, and in every iteration num1 will keep on increasing. 10, it will print 10 with space. 11, it will print 11 with space, and so on and so forth. So let's go ahead, save this, run it and see the output. So as you see, we get the string of all the numbers between 10 to 20 with a space. Now let us check if both the numbers are equal, if it works for that also. So our output is 10. So in this video, we saw how to work on Eclipse. We saw how to download Eclipse, set up a workspace, and set up a project for our work. We learned to work with conditional statements, providing conditions using if and also using a while loop. And we also learned how to compile and run a program from Eclipse. Also how to check for what error is there in our program. So I hope you enjoyed this particular problem. Thank you for watching, and happy coding.